Our ultimate goal is to achieve complete carbon neutrality by 2050. In order to hit that target, we must make our new cars all non-gasoline by 2040.
Usually, when we think about the future of cars, EVs often dominate the conversation. But while most companies are competing to build a better EV, Honda is creating something different, and that is hydrogen technology. This was suggested by the Honda CEO in a recent interview. According to the Honda CEO, the target is carbon neutrality by 2050. But the latest Honda car is already achieving that. We're talking about a car that can be filled in just a few minutes, produces zero harmful gases, and can serve as a mobile generator during emergencies. But first, why has Honda decided to follow the hydrogen route amidst all of the abundant resources available? Let's find out. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos like this. Why hydrogen? For one reason, hydrogen is the most abundant element in the universe. In fact, in fuel cell vehicles, it reacts with oxygen from the air during combustion to produce electricity and gives out water vapor as waste. This mechanism between hydrogen and oxygen gives hydrogen a huge environmental advantage over petrol and diesel engines, which release carbon dioxide, nitrogen oxides, and other pollutants to the atmosphere. But one might say, EVs do not also produce harmful gases to the atmosphere. So there's no need for a hydrogen-powered vehicle. Well, the answer is simple. While EVs do not produce a large amount of toxic gases, they contain batteries that require hours to fully recharge. To put this into perspective, let's say you drive a typical battery-powered EV like the Tesla Model 3. You might have to wait around 20 to 50 minutes at a fast charging station for an 80% charge, whereas with a hydrogen-powered vehicle, you could be back on the road in less time. You'll agree that this is a win of convenience for people who don't have easy access to charging stations and who want to save time. Now, Honda, with its revolutionary tech, is changing that story. Honda has had quite a history with making hydrogen-powered vehicles. It didn't just start today. Let's take you through that journey. Honda didn't just wake up one morning and decide, let's try hydrogen. Their relationship with hydrogen fuel cell technology has been brewing for over two decades. Yes, long before most people even knew hydrogen cars were a thing. It all started in 2002 when Honda introduced the FCX, the first fuel cell car to be the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, and the California Air Resources Board for everyday use. Then, after seeing the lapses of the FCX, they stopped its production. Fast forward to 2008, Honda unveiled the FCX Clarity. This car was so ahead of its time that some people called it the car from 2030. The Clarity produced zero tailpipe emissions and showed the world that fuel cell vehicles could be both eco-friendly and elegant. Then came 2016, when Honda launched the Clarity fuel cell, which took things to a whole new level. With an impressive range of about 366 miles on a single tank, it could travel farther than many battery electric vehicles of the same era and without the long charging times. Yes, companies like Toyota with their Mirai and Hyundai with the Nexo were also pushing into hydrogen territory. But Honda's approach stood out because, unlike others, they were focused on making hydrogen fuel cell technology practical and comfortable for everyday drivers. They wanted it to be as normal as owning a regular Honda Civic. A major milestone came in 2020, when Honda partnered with General Motors, GM, to co-develop next-generation fuel cell systems that were smaller, more durable, and more affordable. This collaboration cut fuel cell production costs by about two-thirds compared to 2016. In 2024, Honda announced plans to produce fuel cell systems at its plant in Michigan, which targeted 2,000 units a year, and will eventually scale to 60,000 units annually by 2030. The use of hydrogen as fuel is an innovation that Honda has exploited for many years. Now, let's look at things from Honda's lens. Let's check out what Honda sees in hydrogen that has made them continually experiment on this element in their vehicles even more than they have on EVs. Both hydrogen and battery electric vehicles, EVs, share the same ultimate goal of eliminating harmful tailpipe emissions, but the way they achieve this is very different. One of hydrogen's most practical advantages is range. Honda's hydrogen-powered models, like the Clarity fuel cell, can travel between 400 and 500 kilometers on a single tank. That's comparable to, and sometimes better than, many petrol cars, and it comfortably beats the range of most affordable EVs, whose range may be around 300 to 400 kilometers. This makes hydrogen vehicles more reassuring for drivers in regions where charging infrastructure is not available. In addition, hydrogen cars also have a weight advantage. Large EV batteries can be extremely heavy. In some cases, it could add about 500-800 kilograms to the vehicle's mass. In contrast to that, a hydrogen fuel cell system is generally lighter, which can improve handling, acceleration, and braking. Lighter vehicles also tend to experience less tire and brake wear, meaning that there would be lower maintenance costs over time. On the other hand, one thing that has hampered the development of hydrogen technology is infrastructure. As of 2025, there are fewer than 1,000 hydrogen refueling stations worldwide, with most concentrated in Japan, South Korea, Germany, and the US state of California. By comparison, EV drivers have access to millions of charging points globally, including over 4 million in China alone. This lack of widespread hydrogen stations means that, for now, hydrogen cars work best in areas where the network is already developed, rather than as a fully global solution. The question is, does Honda have any plans to solve this issue? The next section looks into that. Recent reports have suggested that Honda is investing in renewable hydrogen production methods, like using solar and wind energy, to split water into hydrogen and oxygen. They're also collaborating with governments and other companies to expand refueling networks. In Japan, Honda has teamed up with JX Nippon Oil and Energy to develop more hydrogen stations. In California, they've partnered with First Element Fuel to improve station availability. And in Europe, Honda is contributing to the Hydrogen Mobility Europe H2ME project, which is building one of the largest hydrogen refueling networks on the continent. Also, Honda and General Motors have been working together on hydrogen tech since 2013. But things kicked into high gear in 2024. That's when their joint venture, Fuel Cell System Manufacturing, FCSM, began commercial production of hydrogen fuel cell systems in Brownstown, Michigan. This facility is the first large-scale factory in the US dedicated to fuel cells, producing systems for everything from future Honda CRVs to heavy-duty trucks and backup generators. With faster, more reliable fuel cells and homegrown production, hydrogen vehicles could soon be practical for daily use and heavy-duty work. If Honda succeeds, hydrogen could become a serious competitor to battery EVs. Recall, for Honda, this isn't about replacing electric cars, but giving consumers more options for clean transportation. A delivery company could choose hydrogen vans to avoid downtime from long charging times. In the same vein, drivers in rural areas without access to charging points could still enjoy clean mobility. And countries with abundant renewable energy could store excess power as hydrogen, which would make them a key player in the global energy transition. By 2030, analysts expect the global hydrogen market to be worth over $300 billion. Honda's early and steady push into this field positions them to take a huge slice of that pie, just as Toyota did with hybrid technology in the early 2000s. Now, Honda is not just making these moves on paper, it has already started unfolding. Yes, with the Honda CRV Hydrogen SUV. Let's take a deep look into it. The Honda CRV Hydrogen SUV is one of Honda's most important steps toward providing hydrogen technology for everyday drivers. One of the CRV Hydrogen's standout features is its dual power system. It has both a hydrogen fuel cell for long-distance driving and a small plug-in battery pack, which can be charged at home or public charging points. This means drivers can use short-range electric power for daily commutes and still refuel quickly with hydrogen for longer trips. On a full hydrogen tank, the car can go about 270 to 300 miles. This makes it cover more distance than most EVs on a single charge. Honda made this car not just to sell a new model, but to show that hydrogen cars can work in everyday life and to help make more clean energy cars in the future. What does the future hold for Honda and hydrogen-powered vehicles? Right now, hydrogen-powered vehicles like the Honda CRV Hydrogen are still kind of rare, but they're gaining real momentum. In 2022, only around 20,000 hydrogen vehicles were on the road worldwide. However, experts predict that number will explode to 1.28 million by 2035, which would grow at an incredible 37.6% per year. That means in just over a decade, hydrogen could be way more practical than electric, especially where charging stations are few and far between. We could even see strong government support for this innovation. This is because right now, the hydrogen market is valued at around $12.6 billion in 2024, and it's expected to climb to $142 billion by 2032. That means a lot of investment and jobs are going into clean hydrogen tech. You'll agree that Honda's hydrogen dream is big. Yes, cars that run on only hydrogen and emit only water as a waste product? Well, that is no pushover. No doubt, if Honda can deliver on this vision, the impact won't just be in the car industry. It could even affect energy, shipping, and aviation. And at the end of that day, create a cleaner future for everyone.